Hi everyone, it's your boy Zach, and this is gonna be a weird one because it's gonna be a really depressing but interesting video. So the February Comic-Con, let me minimize this. I had some problem the other day on the video when I uploaded it, even though the window was behind, it kept popping up. So I had to re-upload it. The February Comic-Con. Now, I like how they're delineating this. February 2019 comic book sales to comic shops. So these numbers oftentimes get bandied about as sales, but they're sales, but they're sales to the stores. They're not sales to the customers. The stores just have to kind of guess what they can sell, and then if they guess wrong, they get stuck with whatever they can't sell. The other thing that's huge in the industry right now is overships. That means a store orders 15 copies of Batman Who Laughs number 3, then they get shipped 20 or 25 or 30. I've heard with Marvel sometimes cases of people reducing it to zero and still getting 10 or getting double. Now, they don't have to pay for the extra books, but they do have to pay for the shipping, for the weight. And then that counts as in these figures, so they can kind of gin the figure. So January was being held up as the take that, you incels, because if you look down at these figures, they were saying, up 7% versus the same month last year, up 13% versus the same month last year. And it was a very, very cocky reaction. The problem with January is that January had a whole bunch of number ones, and it had, the number two issue of something that had sold really well. So this was a twitch. Comic book industry is not even in the hospice anymore. It's in the morgue. It died. But, the body's still twitching and letting out some gas. That's War of the Realms crossover next month. But things settled back. When you have a month that doesn't have a bunch of number ones, ho-ho, amazingly. Look at that. Captain Marvel and Guardians of the Galaxy were number 2 and 3. Let's see where they are just a month later. Let's see where Captain Marvel... Are you effing kidding me? Captain Marvel... 111,000 for issue one. 1 month later, 37,000. The other one that was big was Guardians of the Galaxy. Number one, 104,000. Let's see where Guardians of the Galaxy... Guardians of the Galaxy only dropped to 43,000. And then Conan did even better, I believe. We'll find that. So anyway, we're going to just start at the beginning. So... I'm actually going to kind of read. I usually skip over this, but it's very important stuff because this is going to be a long video as well. Where what we're going to see is a complete lack of leadership and truth. What we're going to see is that the people at the very, very bottom of sales are the tastemakers, the shot callers, and the people at top who kind of have a de facto leadership position, even though they aren't editors or executives. They kowtow, and that's why everything is, stores are going out of business. So Comic-Con says, and the guy who writes this, I believe his name is like John Jackson Miller. It sounds like a fur trapper in the 1800s. After a rebound in the number of new comic book releases in January. What? After a rebound in the number. Okay, so basically it's a fancy way of saying there's a lot of number ones. February 2019 returned to the trend with the smallest numbers of new comics released since Diamond Comics Distributors. So last month was a ton of number ones, and this is the opposite, very few number ones. There were no first issues in the top nine at all. 60 fewer new comics were released versus the same month in 2018. 60 fewer titles. New comic sales were off 8.4%, the lowest figure since May 2011. dollars were down just 6%. Dollars were down 6%. Don't say just 6%. The dollars were down. This is an up economy. It's a good economy. It's a booming economy. It's incredibly low unemployment. It's superheroes being the most freaking popular thing there is. An extraordinarily average movie, Captain Marvel, I think it's already made like $800 million in like not even 2 weeks. And we see they can't sell anything. Retailers are orders are down 5% and the lowest figure since March 2012. Correct me if I'm wrong, economists or economist-ish people. March 2012, we were still in the recession, right? Either it was in the tail end of the recession or we were still in it. I'm pretty sure it was still in it. DC has announced plans to reduce its periodical offerings. Now, they gave the bullshit excuse that they couldn't find enough talented pros to fill out their roster. This is weak, and this is embarrassing because Dan Didio, like I said, I don't like DC. I don't think it's a bad company. I'm not into their characters and their style of comics, but it's usually pretty solid. And that was probably the weakest thing I've ever heard Dan Didio say. He has a DC artist, no longer DC artist, that is, geez, Ethan Van Sciver's on his third Cyberfrog. It's for a third cover. He's going to have $100,000 by tomorrow. It's been up for like a week. It's insanity. So half of the drop came from DC alone. And DC is not half the industry. It's like a third. Its slate was chopped by a full third from 88 to 59. DC's stated goal was to improve the performance of its individual titles. That's why it was at least partially successful in this, with the publisher's overall dollar sales down 15%. Okay, so basically they're saying we cut the titles by a third, but our income only went down by 15%. So, you know, they're trimming the wait, I don't think trimming the fat is the correct analogy. They're getting rid of the losers. So Image likewise offered many fewer new comics, dropping from 70 last February to 47. This isn't free fall anymore. This is crib death. Oh my gosh. Comic books in 2019 now have the life expectancy of a second lieutenant in Vietnam in 1968. Or a random serf in the Middle Ages? Like, wow. Marvel, meanwhile, grew its slate with 5 more comic books and 9 more graphic novels released than in the previous February. This is their flood the shelves strategy. And it appears to have benefited from it, selling 9% more dollars worth of material versus its performance. Diamond also liquidated many leftover Marvel variants. Okay, I don't know. That's it. Captain Marvel saw many new releases in advance of the movie, including True Believers. Captain, reorders something. Okay. So let's just get right to it. So I got to just, we're going to compare 1 month ago. 1 month ago, you had 4 books selling 100,000 or more. This one, just one. It's Batman Who Laughs, which is apparently doing fantastically. Batman, I don't like Tom King's run. People like it. Although, like I said, every store I go to, every store has 20 unsold issues of every single issue. Copies of every single issue. Venom, which I'm hearing good things. I'm not into this Venom because it's a very Scott Snyder-y Venom. He can't just be an alien who they met on, what was it, Battleworld. It has to be like the beginning of the universe, you know, the God, the brow, the sweat from his brow dropped into the first star, and it's a virus, it's a symbiote, it's a whatever, it's a bacteria. I don't need it that complicated, but I respect this book. Heroes in Crisis, this is complete trash, but I don't know, people like Tom King. Amazing Spider-Man, this is the one that impresses me the most. Because, you know, I railed against Nick Spencer and he came back strong. He just does normie, straightforward stories. And we're actually going to see that that is the, I was going to say deep bench, but I don't think I'm using that correctly. The locus of success, you know, the concentration of success is normie superhero fare. Venom, Batman, Spider-Man, Flash is doing outstandingly well. Can somebody explain to me why issue 64 of Flash is in the top 12? Avengers? Has Avengers been doing good? These things where they put, they do that, whatever you call it, group of people, conglomerate, whatever you call it, when Jim Zub, who's the other guy? Jeffrey Dalton and Mark Waid, when they do that little brain trust, they're on their, I think, second crossover, and that stuff does good. People like it. Daredevil, number one. I am sad because that is really soft. Although it's not really a number one. It's just they had a monthly, and then they had like a month of doing a miniseries, and then they relaunched the monthly as a number one. So you can't go to that well that many times. Detective Comics is doing good. Flash is doing really good. Justice League is doing good. So we're seeing all, you know, it's normie superhero fare. And the Conan books are doing good, but they just started. We got to see what they settle at. Wonder Woman, surprisingly, I got it. Doff my cap. What's her name? Geoella Wilson. She's on, and it's doing good. I actually dipped out of it, not because it was SJW, just because I got a little bored. But I remember it being fairly straight down the middle. Guardians of the Galaxy, I haven't read this one. I've heard good things. Star Wars. Oof, Star Wars is kind of dipping. What's going on there? If you're a Star Wars reader of the comics, please explain to me. Hulk Marines is just sad. It number one at 38,000. It's going to be at nothing within three months. Conan the Barbarian at three. What was the number one for the last month? There's another something. Oh, because jeez. Marvel, like, they have no faith in themselves. Conan the Barbarian, one, does really good. Okay, so let's build up the franchise. Oh, no. Just make it every 2 weeks, and by three, we're down at, by issue three, we're at 38,000. Brilliant. Great. And they launched a second title, Savage Sword of Conan, which was, it didn't even open that good. It opened at number 47,000. And they're putting them on an Avengers team. They're stupid. They're idiots. Daredevil 2? Oh, again, they're putting stuff out twice a month. It's not good. That thing about putting stuff out twice a month, it doesn't work. Miles Morales is, you know, settling number 3. Tony Stark, honestly, this is, okay, I'm just going to say effing. This is effing embarrassing. Tony Stark, probably the most popular superhero for normies. If you went out to normies right now and you said, who's your favorite superhero? They're probably going to name Batman, Captain America, or Tony Stark. Tony Stark, Iron Man, 33,000. Wow. Catwoman doing fairly solidly. A bunch of number ones for just a mini series. Deadpool. Oh my god, I love Deadpool. Yeah, they've been shitting the bed on Deadpool. Incredibly popular. Everyone's heard of him. 31,000. Then we get into the second issue of Savage Sword of Conan. 30,000. Captain Marvel, Braver and Mightier. 28,000. This is the one that just showed how far they've fallen. Friendly Neighborhood Spider-Man. Sad. It's looking like, and I remember like Chip Zdarsky, he was doing good. He had a bad start to Spectacular Spider-Man, but the numbers were always soft. They're just like going crazy with Spider-Man product. It was killing my channel. I was doing like six of them a month. I was like, nobody wants to watch that stuff or watch videos on it. So it looks like, sadly enough, the market is so pathetic right now that it can only handle one Spider-Man title. Nightwing is doing solid. X-Force, solid. Female Fury is a number one at 26,000. That's sad. Buffy the Vampire Slayer. I was talking to a friend. I was like, with very few exceptions, Buffy, I believe, is with Dark Horse. With very few exceptions, I don't think licenses are worth it, because you got to pay that money. You got to chip in a percentage. And they think it's like, oh, we're going to get that big audience. But it's really a smaller part of the comic book audience. And I think they do okay when you put them on Amazon and stuff like that. But Punisher, embarrassing. Everyone knows that people love the Punisher. 23,000. Doctor Strange, it fell down too. Black Panther, yeah. This is just like, this is like the lowered expectations. Oh, it's doing good. 20,000. Although for an Image book, Magic Order by Mark Miller, that's quite good. Man and Superman, I was kind of disappointed. When I first saw this, I was disappointed because it's down, you know, in the 80s. It's 19,000. But it was a $10 book. Now, it was also what they used to call prestige format. But I know it's not that expensive to print it. So this one was nice and profitable. Black Panther versus Deadpool. Oh my God, Deadpool. And this is just where it starts getting sad. These numbers are sub 20,000. We are not even below the top 100. 20,000 is at number 83. And now we just start getting Champions relaunched with no fanfare, with no reason. It's like the same storyline. It's the same writer. They just relaunched it for a lazy little bump for number one. Let's see what they got for that cheap ass bump for a relaunch they didn't even tell anyone about. So go to, okay, Champions. Wow, they relaunched at 30,000, and by number two, 18,000. Pathetic. Red Sonja, not kind of soft. 17,000. Although I've heard that's like a dependable hit for Dynamite. As Guardians of the Galaxy, really, really low, 16,000. Now we're starting to get into indie stuff, and sadly enough, we're starting to get into DC. DC is hurting. Vertigo was a complete disaster, and the Bendis thing of giving Bendis like six different books, it's not good. His book, Naomi, on the second issue was 15,000. And again, we're getting into like Mark Miller stuff. Well, he's really a little industry. I mean, his stuff doesn't sell a lot, but it's solid. Ironheart, 14,000 on issue 3. West Coast Avengers getting canceled, as predicted, 13,000. And some of these I don't even know anything about. Shuri, 13,000. I'm shocked it's 13,000. I'm shocked it's not lower than that. This is just embarrassing. Miss Marvel, the hit. Miss Marvel, the hit. So great. It's been relaunched 3 times in 5 years. 12,000. I think that's even a little. No, that's lower. Because it used to be that Miss Marvel and Captain Marvel were kind of near each other, but they just relaunched it. Monstrous, which I've heard good things. People really like that. Sonic the Hedgehog. Okay. Middle West, East of West. Where's West of West? That's weirdly enough, they're twins. Umbrella Academy, I think that's not with the original creators, but I've heard people are looking for that. Die Die Die, Robert Kirkman, 11,000. And for indies, that's actually okay. John Wick, this one surprised me. John Wick with Dynamite has been a complete disaster. I just bought it today, so I'm gonna do that one soon. 10,000 on issue 5. What'd it do? Scooby Apocalypse. What is with this book? This thing's just been struggling forever and not getting canceled. Ouch! Oh! Okay, this might be... No, I think this is it. Oh! I gotta go back. I gotta go check if it's January. Okay, so it was a reprint. Okay, I was like, that's gonna be bad. So Marvel Comics Presents premiered at 30. That's not good. That thing is gonna get. That's not gonna get to 12 issues. That's a disaster. Power Rangers books, which I've heard are good, are solid. And 9,000. What are we looking at? Shatterstar. They're still putting that thing out. Oh my gosh, that was terrible. 8,000 at issue 5. Why are they even still doing it? Silencer getting canceled. That's a good book, but just never found an audience. Unbeatable Squirrel Girl. Now I have to check because this looks really low. Number 41, less than 8,000. Is that the only one? So there's three of them, but the others are reprints. Oh, that's embarrassing. Okay, so, ouch. The hits, they will always lie to you. Son of Amunot, all those shill media, they will lie to you and say Unbeatable Squirrel Girl is a hit. Well, it's only been out for a couple of years and it's at less than 8,000. So then we're into like just like the mediocre, okay-ish indie sales. Cemetery Beach, Warren Ellis. I've heard good things, but I flipped through it. It didn't look interesting to me. I didn't buy it. Maneaters, honestly, for as bad as Maneaters is, doing 7,500 on issue 6 is fairly okay. I heard some good stuff about Bitterroot. And then we're into the Archie and the Valiants and, oh God, Hex Wives. Issue 5, 6,700. Murder, this one bums me out. Murder Falcon is only doing 6,600 on issue 5. I think it's going to do really good in trade, but that one bums me out. G.I. Joe, they never do very good. This is just a bunch of indie stuff at this point. But this is a D. So if you're wondering why is a DC, why is United States versus, that's because that's Bendis, Portland Mafia. It's Michael Avon Oming, whatever you say it. Yeah, that's not doing good. And then this is pathetic. Goddess Mode, Vertigo, issue 3. 6,200. That is, I can't believe Andy Corey has a job. Like, that is a disaster. Unstoppable Wasp, which they brought back because of spite. I think it's doing on issue 5 of this second run, I believe it's selling less than the final issue of the first run. So this one is just a complete fraud and just done out of spite. And then, okay, so now we're just into like this just super indie stuff and just Marvel books that are published out of spite. Trying to see if there's anything interesting here. I've heard Turok's okay. I read one issue of it. I couldn't even finish it. It wasn't bad. I just was not into it. This is a horrible selling indie stuff. Although if you think about it, these are bad sales. Like 5,000, like almost no one's making money on that team. They're a third of what Marvel makes. They're a third of they're jeez. Ms. Marvel and Squirrel Girl are said to be incredibly popular hits. They sell 12,000 and 8,000. Indie book doing 3,000 looks respectable by comparison. Savage Dragon. I can't imagine like being 30 years into your career and selling 3,500 copies and like why do you go on? And then we just get into like this. Now, this is a lot of reprints. If you're like, why is Spider-Man only selling 3,000? Because it's a reprint. Reprint of Unbeatable Squirrel Girl is 2,900. And then this gets into Lumberjanes. Lumberjanes is one of those ones where people have said that it was actually always fake news that it was hit. Supposedly, it was a hit a couple years ago, but I heard it was a lot of overships and some other possible shenanigans. So this is the one that is actually really, really weird because Wrong Earth, it's from Ahoy. Okay. Ahoy is the Wrong Earth was really, really good. And I bought the first issue and I've never seen the second issue anywhere. And they're saying, oh, it's a hit, but it's at 306. It's not a hit. That's doing really poorly. Wrong Earth is a good book. And Wrong Earth is about to go on hiatus for 6 months while Jamal Igel draws White, the sequel to Black, which is tracking to make slightly more than half as much as the original. So walk me through the thinking on that. Just a bunch of stuff I haven't heard of, reprints. So here's an interesting one. Punchline, from Antarctic. This is Antarctic's. Honestly, this is a hit for them at 2000. And I heard good things. They're on issue 4. And we're going to see. It's I forget the names of these guys, but they do Antarctic. They do good stuff. They stay out of trouble. They're just doing something they like. I've heard good things. But then we're going to see who they're selling better than. And it's the people who are the shot callers. It's LaGuardia 1800. And then we're going to see the All-Stars, the Twitter All-Stars down here, way down here, way, way, way down here. Oh my gosh. So where do we got it? We got Kwanzaa and Max. Now, I have been kind of just, you know, I used to talk about them a lot a year ago and I kind of laid off for various reasons. But one of the reasons is I just had made my point. But this has to be shown. If you go on Twitter and you would see the deference that Kwanzaa and Max get, when you see the lies of people who obviously do not read their stuff, portraying them as a big hit and super popular, and then when you see the sales on their books, Kwanzaa on issue 2 of a miniseries, 1,200. Mags on issue 3 of a miniseries, 1,100. There are trash Black Mask books that I've never even heard of. Snap, Flash, Hustle is outselling them. And it's just pathetic. Again, these are the people at the very bottom, the dregs of the industry. But Twitter has destroyed the comic book industry, and these are the people that the people at the top defer to. And I'm going to protect you, all this stupid stuff. Now this is just a bunch of reprints, so these are just kind of worthless. But this is, you might say, what's the point of Marvel putting out a reprint of X-Men Gold number 2 for 900, flooding the shelves. They're just hoping that guy, he gets to the Marvel section, he just say, okay, give us two of that, one of that, because shelves are not infinite. Marvel's ability to print out crap is infinite, but a store only has limited shelf spot. Every spot that goes to Iceman 6 reprint for 989, that's a spot that a good book like Wrong Earth could have taken, and it doesn't have it. So this is just a bunch of whatever. Sukaban Turbo. Okay. Whatever. Bunch of reprints, and that's about it. So after these are all the floppies, and then let's look at the graphic novels. This is interesting. That's actually not bad. Mr. Miracle, although I actually know that is bad, because that was put on the same level playing field as like that and Batman White Knight, and Batman White Knight did like tens of thousands every time it was printed, so this appears to be this is better than the other one. So there's 8300, and then we're down at, look at this, to be the number 2 book you sell 3200. What? Ethan sold like 11,000, and he just sold 1,000 in like the last week. So, okay, yeah, because this isn't that interesting. But anyway, this is the dead American comic. It's dead. It just died. It's still twitching. Still letting out some gas. It's still, you know, equalizing pressure or whatever they call it. But it's over, man. It's lights out. Meanwhile, the people at the top who should show some kind of leadership, Scott Snyder, Tom King, they completely abdicate leadership to kiss the ass of Twitter frauds. People who, if you go to their timeline, it's all about their identity, because that's the only way they get books. And by the way, Mags has a new miniseries announced, I'm not kidding, like every 3 or 4 weeks. Kwanzaa is a complete failure, but has 6 pages of glowing press. Let's look at a good book. Why not for The Other Earth, which is actually good. So things are really, really bad, and it's shocking. The little successes are only done by short money, loser money. The short money is the loser money, and leaving stores with a bunch of unsellable stock. Conan, 100,000 on, honestly, for as big as the property as Conan is, I'm not impressed by that 100,000. And then it's down to 30,000 by issue 3. Pathetic. Clowns. Absolute clowns. So anyway, thanks for watching. Subscribe. Make sure you still subscribe. Hit the bell for notifications. Thanks to everyone giving to the GoFundMe and the Indiegogo. And I'll have a new comic review up tomorrow. Thanks. Bye.